Art is important to mankind's existence.
You're going to the middle of the woods by a lake to talk about really radical ideas.
It's not just about bringing people together, but you have to bring people together that are different.
Looking at the program for the symposium, it's rather extraordinary. It's like a very detailed palette for a painter.
Welcome to Information, Space, and Time, Art, Creativity, and Learning in the 21st Century, a special symposium celebrating the 50th anniversary of Interlochen Arts Academy. Welcome to Interlochen Center for the Arts.
But I wouldn't pull the splinters from my heart any more than Christ would pull the thorns from his crimson head.
Over 2.5 years ago, when we first started to plan the 50th anniversary for Interlochen Arts Academy, we knew that there were two very important parts of it. One was the historical part, and that included touring and reunions and helping people see the incredible legacy. But there were a lot of questions about where are we going? And out of that came the idea for a symposium in which we'd look at all the arts and really have some difficult questions about where they're going.
Lots of people need partners to dance. It's a quote. To make all art too.
It has brought together leaders in education and the arts from across the country, people who have been successful with the work that they have done in very unique fields as well as more traditional fields.
Well, it's certainly exciting to have such incredible writers such as Tony Kushner and Carolyn Forché in one room. I mean, they're both dealing in different mediums, but they're both poets in their own right. They're both also looking at worldviews that are incredibly complex.
The colonel returned with a sack used to bring groceries home. He spilled many human ears on the table. They were like dried peach halves.
Because I think it's important for the students to know how we got to be where we are today and how that began in our childhoods and how we made our decisions and what happened to us that brought us to the place where we are now.
I want to say this again because I want to put this in your minds a little bit. You're not consumers. You're citizens of a republic and the world. Don't let anyone turn you into an economic automaton.
I certainly support any attempt to bring people from different artistic disciplines and different life disciplines from science and the arts together because I think those kind of conversations are almost always of some value and generative. I feel very, very strongly that one of the greatest creations of the human race is undergraduate liberal arts education, which is very specifically, you know, but, you know, it's, that's so great that we're applauding the liberal arts education. But, you know, it's not vocational training.
We wanted to make sure that people had multiple ways that they interacted with these great performers and speakers and presenters. And every conference participant went to a discussion group, the same discussion group 5 different times, to deal with different post-session discussions and discussion questions, very rich discussions there.
The future of art is inextricably woven with technology's effect on humanity.
There is a fundamental question. Can the planet hold that many people? What is the capacity limit of the world? I think what has been created in this 4-day symposium is almost a learning journey, you know, that we'll experience as a collective. And so we'll enter one way and we'll all exit, you know, kind of being transformed.
You know, there are many ways to view reality, and our definition as people in the West, how we fit into reality, is very different than most of the rest of the world.
And one of the quandaries for our future is how we put things in balance as far as the technologies we use to express ourselves. So both artists and scientists have a very important role to play in the reshaping of society.
Excellent. Okay, open them and you'll find the hand crisscross. Beautiful, much better. Okay.
Each person sitting in that auditorium today has solutions embedded in them and who they are and how they think, and we just need to let that emerge.
Now, everybody thought it was kind of funny, but everyone was very serious about it. We actually were then able to pop it up on the big screen for the entire audience to see, and it was extraordinary. And I think it raises some questions. What is movement? What is dance? How can we be expressive individuals? Those are big questions in our very tech, media-driven society.
We have some questions that we'll start off with, and then we'll begin to take tweets from the audience.
Well, the symposium is about the future of the arts. So these panels and discussion groups are to really look collaboratively at what is the future of the arts.
The campfire of the story on stage and you're leaning in around it, it's a very human moment. And that's what will draw us together, and that's what will ensure the future of reading and publishing, I think.
So to pull together something that's optimistic and to look at the future through a collaborative and artistic lens is a positive step forward.
And I also believe in the efficacious act of art, that art can change lives and is an incredibly healing force. I want it to continue to stay strong, which means that I'm responsible as an adult in that.
Where are my sons?
Dead. I killed them, Jason.
Really, it's time?
Yeah, I love you.
Oh, but shouldn't I get Mom and Dad?
No, I...
I mean, already I'm walking away from so much with having worked with the students. And I think that is always one of the greatest learning tools. It's why I also continue to teach.
The symposium's about looking forward to the next 50 years.
It's always an opportunity to feed off of one another's ideas, forge new connections.
Whether you're a student or a professional musician, a teacher from another organization, you're trying to start an arts program in your own schools.
We have strength in diversity, and since we're all making culture together, we're all being influenced by each other.
Well, we're already thinking about symposium in 2013, and I think we'd like to bring back two or three people in some very interesting collaborative roles and actually have them collaborate with students and with our groups. What greater opportunity? And it can happen at no other place, as far as I'm concerned, than in Ilocken.